Welcome to Office Mechanics. Coming up on the show, we're going to take an early look at the new Office 2016 public preview. We're also going to take a look at the new Office for Windows 10 on a phone. And stay tuned as we look at what's new in Excel, Word, PowerPoint, and more on the show. I'm joined again by Ben Walters. Welcome.
Thanks. Great to be here, Jeremy.
So last time we took a look at Outlook and some of the new things that we can do in Mail, but I want to really do a round trip of all the great things that we've done from Office end to end on Windows and on the phone.
Sure. So one of the places I want to start is in Word. We've had co-authoring the online version of Word now for a really long time, and I'm really excited to be able to show you now. And if we switch over to Demo Machine 1, our new co-auth experience that's happening in the rich client. So you can see here, as I've opened up this document, I can see flags of where people are. I can see those moving around my document here. And you'll also see as they start to edit, that text comes straight through for me. No more having to worry about saving or hitting refresh to get those changes come through. Everything just streams straight back through to my machine and is auto-saved to everyone else who's editing that file as well.
And that's really amazing because we've had these experiences in Office Online for a while now with Word Online. And also in PowerPoint and Excel as well, but really the rich clients is where most people are getting the majority of their work done from Word's perspective. This gives them the ability to do that real-time co-authoring, that real-time typing that you're seeing here on the screen. Amazing, great stuff coming there. But beyond what we're doing there, we're also doing a bunch in Excel too, right?
That's right. It's been a really long time since we've had any new charts come into Excel. And I'm really happy to announce that we have 6 new chart types coming into Excel in the new version in Excel 2016. This is really based off the fact that data visualization and the way people work with data has changed over the time since we last had, you know, new chart types come in. So if we switch over to Demo 2 here, you can see I have my new Excel chart types up. This is the waterfall chart. Great for being able to show up financial data and gains and losses as part of that. We also have this great new tree map chart as well, where you can see the leaf nodes of those rectangles really kind of showing you the values there. And while this tree map chart is really great at showing you overall averages of data, it probably doesn't show me the structure. So it's really easy for me to go into here, you know, change my design out, and I'll switch this over here to one of our other new chart types, which is called Sunburst. And you'll see, again, we get that data reworked in there. It's being changed to look like a sunburst, which means I also get the view of the structure as well as the value. And the big piece on these new charts is they're built on a new platform, which means we can update them and continue to work on those as we go forward. So you'll see new interactive charts and things come through as we move forward.
And some of the things also across both Word and Excel that you might be seeing with an eagle eye, things like Tell Me also being integrated in all the apps to be able to find functionality very quickly. But one of my favorite features in Excel is actually something around security and preventing data loss. So we flip over to Demo 3 here. We have a brand new capability inside of Excel as we're typing. And you'll notice I have credit card information here, but I'll see a policy tip as I'm actually inputting that information in the document, and it will say exactly what I'm doing wrong here, because we want to be able to include the user in the compliance process to make sure they're educated in terms of what's going on, make sure that Excel, kind of like we had in Mail in the past, actually informs that user of any sensitive information they might be working on. And at the back end, it will do things like be able to lock down permissions to just the author of that document. So really cool stuff coming, not only in the visualization side of Excel, but also with DLP. And this DLP data loss prevention is going to be available across Word and PowerPoint as well.
That's right, really making sure that the data you've got, wherever you've got it, is protected. So Next, I'd like to switch over to Demo 2 and really shift gears into Mail. And Mail is still where we spend a lot of our time today. You know I'm always triaging my mail before I get up. Even before I get out of bed, the first thing I do is check my email. But when we look at Outlook, this is where people spend a lot of their day. So what I want to do here is show you very quickly one of the great new features we have called Modern Attachments. So here I can go and create a new email. And historically, if I was to attach a document to an email, I'd have to go and find that document. Where was I working on it? But we've included now a recent used item list. So as I open up the attach file dialog or the attach file icon, I get a list of all the documents that I've recently been working on. Now some of these documents have a nice little cloud icon on them. That means they're stored in OneDrive and I can share a link directly to those documents. I also have a list of the documents that are sitting on my PC as well. So if I want to attach those documents through, I can do that. Now as I go ahead and click, that document will get attached to my email just like an attachment. And you'll see here it actually goes in, looks and feels like an attachment.
So what the great thing is here, it's actually finding all the documents you've been working on. So it saves me personally a ton of time as I'm working through files, because I don't always know exactly where I save them on the local machine. That finds that for me as well. And then with the cloud sharing here, it means that we don't have to worry about the version control issues you might have on sending that document to 10 people and having to collate all those different edits into one doc. Now we can actually centrally author against the same file.
That's right. And if I wanted to actually go and correct the permissions on that, I can do that as well. So I don't always have to share documents to edit. I can very easily come down and change that to be just to view. So if I want someone just to review something and not make changes to it, I can set that in my Outlook as well.
So that's a beginning or a taste of things that we've done in Office 2016, and then what you'll be able to see in the public preview. But I know that we want to be able to see what's on Windows Phone. We're going to switch gears here, and we're going to go back to Demo 3 and show what's new on Windows Phone. This is really exciting because we're bringing a lot of functionality in such a small form factor.
This is. And so what I have here is my Windows Phone 10 device. I'm going to open that up, and you can see right there on my start menu, I have Outlook, I have a new mail, new calendar, Excel, Word, and PowerPoint applications right there ready to go. Like I said, I'm going to stay in the mail vein and start in Outlook. And you can see we have this great new fresh view of Outlook ready to go through and work on my email. Now, with my email, I have this ability as well to use swipe gestures to be able to triage that email. So here you've got delete. I've probably got like a mark as unread in there. I could change that to flag or archive. So it's really simple for me to go through and process that email and get it triaged and ready to go. The other great benefit we have here is that if I go and open up this email here from Julia and I want to reply to that, we're using the Word editor that exists within the Office Universal applications right here on the phone. So this gives me a couple of great benefits. First of all, I have all of the editing capabilities that I get within Word, first of all, in editing my email. And I also have this great ability to be able to do inline editing. So where historically I'd have to go through and rewrite an email from top to bottom, I can now do things like, say, refer to my answers in line and simply go and respond to those as I need to, making it much simpler for me to work with that. The other piece we have with mail as well is we know that you like to work with mail, but you also like to work with your calendar. And we've integrated the calendar directly into my mail experience. So if I open up my menu, I can go straight down to the bottom here, select calendar, and I'm linked straight through to my schedule and what's going on within my calendar there as well.
So that's great to see, but even beyond mail and calendar, the app experiences for Word, Excel, PowerPoint have changed quite a bit and have added a lot of new functionality. Why don't you show us PowerPoint?
So let's have a look at PowerPoint here then. There we go, there's my PowerPoint presentation. Looking beautiful, it's a nice rich experience. I have my slide navigator on the left-hand side there. I can also use swipe gestures to be able to navigate through my slides as I want to go through that deck and review things. But because we have these great devices that can connect to projectors, I can also put this straight into projection mode. And when I do that, I get all of those animations, slide transitions come up, and so no longer do I have to spend time with a PC connecting up to projectors and those kind of things. I can bring my phone in and actually do my deck right there from within my meeting on my phone. We also have all the features you see in the Universal apps as well. So if I want to go and ink and draw attention to certain areas on my slides, I can do that as well just with touch.
Very cool. So you can use your phone basically as the presentation PC or computer for an actual presentation using things like Miracast. Very exciting. And even beyond that, we've done a lot in Word as well, right?
So let me open that up and show you. Word here is amazing. We have this beautiful, rich document, full fidelity view. I can see all of my graphics, all of my feedback that's gone through in that document. If I zoom in there, you'll see I've got some comments that have come through in that. Really easy for me to be able to work with that document and see everything that's in there. You'll also notice if I open up the menu at the bottom, that same palette UI that I had when I was in Outlook is also in here. So we have a familiar experience as we make our way across the applications. And it doesn't matter where I am, I have access really easily to all of the functionality that sits within Word, making it really easy for me to work with this on the go.
So really, really great stuff here. Of course, we couldn't cover all the bases in terms of all the different apps that we had in the time that we have today. But what you're seeing is a greater focus in terms of collaboration. Also, better connection to Office 365 and web services, better visualization in Excel, fuller and richer fidelity on a phone device, and we've got the compliance and all of the security controls around things like Excel, Word, and PowerPoint using features like DLP. So really, really great set of new features. Thanks for showing us those today, Ben. Of course, all this information and more can be found on the Office blogs, also on Office Mechanics Wednesdays or as news breaks. Thank you all for watching, and goodbye for now. We'll be right back.